Morning, Dex. Morning to you too. Morning, everybody. So, what we got today is we're gonna take on the cornfield. We gotta get that cut down. Our corn has run its course. So, well, actually what it really is corn was doing great, and then we had some really frosty nights. Four right in a row we had nights in the 20s. Ooh, there she is. And see that rolling? We had four nights right down in the 20s, and that pretty well took care of it right there. Big deal, that time of the year. So we'll get the cornfield cut down today, and I'll go back up with the discs. All right, now that's greased up. I'm gonna go cut down the cornfield, and then I'll come back and I'll grab the discs and I'll go up and see what we can do to get that broken up. It should break up real good. The corn is very brittle, dry right now. Last weekend and then into early this part of the week, we had four nights right in a row below 30. Two of them, one was 23, one was 24. So the corn's pretty well done. I'm not 100% sure how well this stuff's either gonna chop up real good, or these stalks are just gonna break when I hit them with the tractor and lay over. Not really sure yet. jump off and see how she's doing. It doesn't look like it's doing too bad. I mean, for a rotary cutter, I mean, this is about, it's about as good as you're gonna get it. That ain't too bad. I mean, there's still some stalks. That's to be expected. And then we'll wait for manure from the farmer down the road. Of course, they're right knee deep in corn harvest, so we'll wait patiently. We'll work around his schedule. And I don't have anything building up under the tractor, so let's keep going.
Thank you.
too bad. Like I said, compared to the job Tim's flail mower did, I mean, this didn't do too bad of a job for a rotary cutter. I mean, the slower I went, the better it did. It was almost painful. But done now, I'll go down and grab the disc and I'll be back.